EA Rocks is awesome. Huh? Oh, the episode. Right. Just a sec. EA's second voice bank, EA Rocks, was released June 27, 2014, and in my video on that release, I talked a lot about EA's standing in the franchise, as well as her, I guess, commercial relationship with the other Vocaloids. I also talked about how much I enjoyed EA, and many people responded saying that they thought EA was alright, but that they liked other Vocaloids more, which is completely fine. I wasn't trying to convince anyone that EA is better than any other Vocaloid, I was expressing my feelings on EA's contribution. Looking back, I noticed that I may have appeared to have overstated how beautiful EA's voice bank is, at least if you've only listened to a few EA songs. The first time I heard EA's voice was through one of her demo songs, Tori no Uta, which is EA's rendition of a song that was originally performed by her voice provider. If you never watched my original History of the Vocaloids episode where I talked about EA, or you've never heard the song before, allow me to play you some of it. That was my introduction to EA, and it completely spoiled me. I instantly fell in love with her voice because of that demo, and come to think of it, the same thing happened to me with her quote-unquote little sister, but that's a topic I will definitely get to later. But more than that, it may have been the point where I realized that Vocaloid could truly become something that would appeal to non-anime fans and non-otaku. I had already heard many Vocaloid songs before I ever learned about EA, of course, great songs, but EA was definitely pivotal in solidifying my view of Vocaloid as a serious tool. Of course, most Vocaloid songs don't sing in that style, and if you look at EA's most popular songs, you'll see that many of them use her voice bank with a high pitch and a fast tempo, so I guess that's just the way the Japanese prefer it. In response to that, EA Rocks improved EA's ability to go higher by making her high notes clearer and allowing her to sing faster. So a lot of EA Rock songs are also done in that style, which isn't my preferred style for EA, but the Japanese apparently find it very cute. Certainly, people use her Rocks voice bank for rock songs too, and Western producers have experimented with EA Rocks quite a bit. I've heard her sing in English, and even surprisingly good Spanish considering the limitations of Japanese consonants. Some producers have pushed EA Rocks' voice higher than EA ever went, making her sound like a young Rana, which is at least something different. But EA Rocks is, in a sense, an update to EA rather than an append or extend voice bank, or at least that's how people have received it. EA Rocks definitely performs better in certain genres than EA's original voice bank, and vice versa, but they have a lot more overlap than, say, Meiko Straight and Meiko Power. As for how popular EA Rocks is, Japanese producers often won't specify which of EA's voice banks they've used in their songs, especially since they're so similar, but I get the feeling it did pretty well. EA has always been a Vocaloid where the songs were about quality more than quantity. She may not have as many songs as other Vocaloids, but nearly half of her songs on Nico Nico are originals written specifically for her. So while the EA Rocks tag may only have about 350 results right now, which is an average amount for 1 year at this point in time, most of them are originals rather than covers. In other EA news, EA Visual Tracks Colorful was supposed to release last year, but it was delayed and will finally be releasing in July 2015 for the PS Vita. I don't own a Vita, and I've heard that it isn't doing all that great right now, but hopefully it will stay afloat long enough for the game to be successful. And finally, EA will be having her first concert in the US at Anime Expo 2015 in Los Angeles, California on July 4th. I'm not sure exactly how the concert will be done. I assume it will use rear projection like we've seen in other Vocaloid concerts, but the promotional video for the event also shows a demonstration of augmented reality projection.
Thank you. 赤い靴をどうしてどうしてなくすのかな。そんな些細な出来事がもう心の隅で積もっていたんだ。おとぎ話のような結末でさえ怖くなっていた。ねえ、もしも今日に生まれたら私はどんな名前をしていて、もし君と出会えなくてもそれでよかったと思えたのかな。涙が溢れて止まらないんだ。前髪気にしないでそのまま駆け出そう。また会えるかな。白い帽子追いかけて笑う響く声。